All right, guys, so let's look at this example here. So every corner, every edge is a carbon, right? So we know that carbon must make four bonds. This carbon here, we see it making one bond to that carbon, so it must have three H's on it to get to four. This carbon here, we see it making one, two, three, four bonds, so it has no more room to accept any hydrogens, so it's fine. This is a carbon here. We see it making one bond, so it must have three H's that we don't see to get it to four. Same with this carbon. We see it making one bond, so it must have three hydrogens on it that we don't see. This carbon here is making two bonds, one, two, so it must have two hydrogens we don't see. And then this carbon here is making one, two, three, four bonds total, so it's satisfied in terms of being tetravalent, has no hydrogens on it at all. So let's count how many total carbons we have. We have one, two, three, four, five, six carbons, so C6. Next, hydrogens. We have 3, 6, 9, 11, 12. And then how many oxygens do we have? We have 2 oxygens. So this would be your molecular formula, C6H12O2. That would be the formula that you should have gotten for this first compound here. Now that we've done that one, try to do this one. This one isn't written as a skeletal formula. I've shown it as an expanded or structural formula. So this one should be a lot easier. Just literally count the number of elements and then give me the structural formula for it. Come back, let's take a look at it once you've done that.